Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding why the British said no to Europe, written by John Pilger. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for political science and public administration optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the exit of Britain from European Union. This editorial is also about what kind of repercussions the world would be facing because of this exit. This editorial is also about the sustenance, the legitimacy, the rationality and the sanctity behind the idea of globalization. This editorial is also about how this Brexit would be affecting the global immigration policies. This editorial is also about how this Brexit could lead to the cementing of the identity politics, how this will be leading to the cementing of fundamentalism, how this will also lead to a situation where the peace and the prosperity and the welfare of the people will be endangered because of the rising specter of terrorism. Now, in order to understand this editorial, first of all, we need to understand about why the exit has taken place. Now, when it comes to the Britain's exit from the European Union, the Britain's marriage with the European Union, it was just like a marriage between the rich and the poor. When you look at the entire structure of the European Union, there are certain poor countries and there are certain rich countries. And because it was an economic union, the kind of the economic integration was huge. It was phenomenal. So when the economic integration gets to such heightened levels, in that situation, the rich countries, in order to sustain this economic union, had to pump money into the central bank of European Union. And this central bank of economic union was funding the populistic policies of certain poor countries in European Union, like pigs countries, Portugal, Italy, Spain, Greece, etc. Now these were the countries that were actually not and still are not in par with the rich countries of the European Union. Now why this European Union was formed? This European Union was basically formed because the capitalist lobby of the Europe, they wanted to extract the market of the other countries. They wanted to protect themselves from a kind of wave that was enveloping the world in the form of communism or socialism. So this idea of European Union basically and rootedly focuses only on enriching the top class, the rich class, the corporate class, the capitalist class at the cost of the poor. Now, after the unfolding of 2008 global economic crisis, the key word here is 2008, you must remember that. Now, after the unfolding of this crisis, economic crisis, Britain had begun to feel the pinch of the austerity measures. Now, these austerity measures led to the pruning of the various social security policies. It led to the pruning of the social security measures that the Britain had been taking care of. Now, once these social security programs were taken off, the pinch was felt basically by the elder section of the society. Now, when it comes to the division of how the people are divided about the Brexit, it is actually a divide between the young generation and the old generation. the generation that was dependent on the austerity measures, and the generation that actually wants to fly to other countries with disregard to the boundaries between the countries. Now, the older section of the society of the England wanted to exit because they really believe that what they were doing is actually they were funding. They were actually paying for the welfare of the citizens of the other countries. खुद के ऊपर खर्चा नहीं कर पा रहे, दूसरे देशों को पैसा देना पड़ रहा है. So this was something that was felt by the poorer and the older section of the society of England, and it is because of that the exit has taken place. Now, what kind of the repercussion this would be having? Now, this repercussion, this Brexit would be testing the very idea of globalization, because this has set up a very wrong precedent. This is actually, you can call it as U-turn for the globalization. Now, from here onwards, the economic integrations will be less than the standard that was set up by the European Union. Because the kind of the standard that was set up by the European Union, it was very, very high standard of economic union. Now, whatever kind of economic union, what kind of integration that the countries will be going into, it will be lesser than this, because they had seen something bad unfolding out of it. Now, the kind of the free trade agreements that would be signed between the countries will be taking care of this aspect. Now, this, now at the face, when you read the title of the editorial, why the British said no to Europe, it seems as if it's just a one question to answer. But actually it is not. It is having in itself a lot number of questions encapsulated, and that really needs to be answered. The bigger question is about how the terrorism, the fight against the terrorism, would strengthen or would weaken because of this thing. Now, when it comes to the fight against the terrorism, now since 2001, 9/11, what we had seen that there has been a stupendous participation. There has been a phenomenal participation by the European nations against the rising Islamic fundamentalism. Now, that fight was because they wanted to protect their economic interests. They believed that their economic interests are entangled, and they really need to get together in order to fight against this menace. Now, what is being endangered is this very idea of togetherness. Now, they don't want to remain together because of the question of economic profits. Now, this Brexit, it has also raised another question. Now, that another question is about the big corporate houses. Now, when you look at the entire economic scenario in the world, now as per the Oxfam report and as per the World Bank's report, there is a high level of inequality existing in the world, and this inequality is actually perpetuating. It is actually sustaining, it is actually widening, it is actually deepening. Now, the gap between the super rich and the super poor is increasing at a tremendous pace. We have people who are having net worth of $30 billion, who are having net worth of $25 billion. And we have people who can't live, who can't afford $1 per day. So such kind of a gap has come into being because of this very globalization. The super rich, they have been able to exploit this economic situation that was created quite well in comparison to the people who are less empowered. So this idea of Brexit is also kind of challenge to the big corporate houses, to the big MNCs, to the migration. And it is actually a win for the leftist lobby, for persons like Jeremy Corbyn, for the parties like Syriza. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 8459400000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes package for civil services preparation. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.